Hey everybody, this is Boot Bear, also known as Dyer, also known as myself. Pretty much, I'm here in my room, and what I want to talk to you guys about was the Chuck Wagon Cowboy, Ron Locke. Great recipes, been watching him for a while, got to meet him in person, really nice guy, really cool guy. Been dying to try some of his recipes out, and one day he came out with the pecan tuna cheese honey wheat wrap. His friends at Damascus Bakeries sent him basically like a little care package type of thing, challenging him to make a recipe using their product. And he did. He used the honey wheat wrap that they make and turned it into a really delicious recipe. Now, I, of course, doctored mine up because the fact is that, out of several reasons, one, I couldn't find certain ingredients, two, I couldn't afford certain ingredients because I'm kind of broke, and three, okay, I said didn't like, or just a couple ingredients I didn't like. There was one ingredient, mainly, main ingredient that I didn't like. I may try it one day with that ingredient in, when I decide to be a little bit more adventurous with it. But I think I was just adventurous enough with the two things that I did leave in that I don't normally eat. So, here we go. What I did for my version of it is that, first off, mine's is it's not a pecan tuna cheese honey wheat wrap. My recipe is a walnut tuna cheese spinach herb wrap. Okay, that's the key difference, and I'll explain why when I go through my recipe. I basically took a package of cream cheese from Target, the whipped, which is 8 ounces. I combined that with 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, 1/2 cup of mayo, Kraft mayo, because that's what I use. I used 1/2 cup of walnuts that are chopped finely. I couldn't find any pecans, that's why it's walnut. Because I don't like olives, I took out the olives. I did, however, instead of the 7-ounce can, the 1 can of 7-ounce tuna, what I did was, because I like mine's a bit meatier, I did 2 cans, which are 5-ounce cans, of the tuna light in water. I strained them, okay, and so they were strained and flaked. Then I took a 1/4 teaspoon of horseradish, and I took 1/2 teaspoon of sweet relish. Okay, now, mind you, I hate horseradish, and I hate sweet relish, but I was willing to give it a try. So, basically, mind you, I'm looking down because that's where my recipe is, yeah, right here. Instead of regular lettuce, I personally love spring mix. I'm a big spring mix person, so I put spring mix in instead. And because I forgot, and I couldn't afford to get already chopped tomatoes, I'm not really good at dicing tomatoes. So what I did was I decided to leave it out, and I still kept the Munster cheese because I love Munster cheese. So that's 2 slices of Munster cheese in each of these. And then I used also 1 tablespoon of mayo for each wrap, just to kind of like settle the items on it. And if you watch Ron's episode, it's episode 20, which I'm going to go ahead and link you everybody to it. Episode 20. And basically, he'll show you exactly how to build the wrap. Now, of course, I was dying to try the Damascus Bakery's honey wheat wrap. But unfortunately, I went to as many Targets as I could that I could find on their map that carried their brand, and I could not find not the honey wheat wrap or pitas, nothing that was Damascus Bakery. So I was a little disappointed. It's not Ron's fault, and I don't know, maybe it's something that Damascus Bakery has to talk over with Target and figure that out, what's going on with that. But I ended up, because I couldn't find Damascus Wheat Grease Honey Wheat Wrap. I went ahead and got the Target wrap, which was a spinach herb wrap. So it's good. It's zero trans fat. And basically, I put that all together and built them up. I tried recording this before, so I already tried it. Love it. But I'm going to try it again for you guys again. And this is what you're looking at. So, I don't know if you guys can see that. The camera. Yeah, there we go. See one right here? I already ate that one. I was too hungry. But if you see, that is really good. And, of course, I need help with my skills. And I'm just turning around that. I'm just making sure it's recording. So I'm going to go ahead and try this one with you guys watching. And here we go. It's so good. Really, really good. Ron, it's good stuff. It's good eating. So I'm going to leave you guys. I'm going to enjoy my wraps and I'll catch y'all later. Alright, again, go to this link, and he's got a whole bunch of recipes. He's known as the Chuck Wagon Cowboy. I'll link you to his Facebook, and I will link you also to his page. Also, Damascus Bakeries, even though I couldn't get to try your stuff, I'm still going to link people to your YouTube page, because I really want people to try your stuff. Alright, guys? Alright, take care. Bye.